Hello friends, welcome to Scholars Learning Classes. Moving towards our next topic of Principle of Management, which is your Fayol's Principle of Management. So friend, Henry Fayol, basically a writer, belongs to some management who had given some of the principle, who had experimented so many things, and after that basically advocated few principles which we are going to learn in our this class. There are basically 14 principles of management which your Henry Fayol had provided to you, and we are supposed to learn them because we are being a part of the management. In case you further you will move towards your higher studies over there as well, you will see that how much your these principles are important for you, not only about the organization or your higher studies, but apart from that in your daily life as well. These are basically linked to your daily life, these are basically linked to your sentiments, nothing else, but these are very common but important as well. As if we talk about the examination point of view as well, one of the question will definitely come from this topic which we are going to learn in our this class, whether it will be for 1 mark or 3 mark, even for 6 marker question, such question can come. Okay, so please be very clear with today's class, please be very concentrated towards today's session. Okay, so friends, coming toward the basic points, basic knowledge, basic concept which we are going to learn in this class, which are the principles of Fayol. So the first principle, as we discussed, that there are 14. So first out of 14, one of 14 of your Fayol's principle is your division of work and specialization. Okay, first of all, taking into consideration your division of work, what we mean by division? Division means dividing. So by division of work we mean dividing the work into small jobs, into small or number of jobs or tasks. Okay, so by division of work we mean the work should be divided into small jobs or tasks which should be performed by some specialized person or the trained employee, and in case one is performing the same task again and again, ultimately he will be called specialized, right? Thus division of work is important so that basically the aim of specialization can be achieved. On the other hand, if the specialization is there, what will happen is those specialized are working the same work again and again, it will ultimately reduces the wastage, reduces the cost and wastage, as well as increases productivity and efficiency. Okay, so friends, this is basically your first principle provided by Henry Fayol. Okay, coming toward the second principle provided by the Fayol, which is your authority and responsibility. These terms basically you will gonna learn in your organizing chapter as well, but here discussing about this, first of all, what we mean by authority and responsibility. So friends, by authority we mean right to order. One is having power that he can order to his subordinate, right to order, and also obtain obedience, which mean that he can obtain that his subordinate is following whatever he had instructed to his subordinate. So in case one is providing with, first of all, what we mean by responsibility? By responsibility we mean obligation to perform some act, job assigned to them. Assigned to them. So friends, tell me one thing. If one is provided with some responsibility, that is, one is provided some job to be completed, right? Then he must be having some rights as well, right? Otherwise, what will happen? Will he be able to perform that responsibility, perform that job? Obviously not, right? Thus, proper volume of your responsibilities and authority should be given to a particular person in case one is supposed to fulfill his job, then he should be given some power, he should be given some right. And in case one person is having some rights, then the same amount of responsibilities should be provided to that person. Otherwise, what will happen is, see, giving authority without fixing responsibility may lead to misuse of authority, because there is excess of authority as compared to responsibilities, right? And in case one is having more responsibilities but less authority, that then what will happen? It will lead to your inefficiency in working. Okay, so friends, that is why the same amount of authority and responsibilities should be given. This is the second principle. Now coming toward the third principle. The third principle provided by Henry Fayol is your discipline. And we all know the meaning of discipline. Discipline means obedience. Obedience to rules and regulations, right? So if we are talking about organization, it means discipline will be referred to the obedience toward organizational rules and employment agreements, which are necessary for the working of the organization, right? And according to Henry Fayol, if we will talk about discipline, require three things. First one is good, superior at all level, clear and fair agreement, and the third one is judicious application of penalties. Which mean, in case one will not comply with the obedience, what he is supposed to comply with, then he should be punished, he should be offended with some penalties, okay? So, this is your third principle. Coming toward the fourth principle, which is your unity of command. If we will talk about this principle in a single line, as per this principle, what it means is one boss for each employee. Or you can say one and only one boss for each subordinate, for every subordinate. As per it, what it means is, as if, tell me one thing, you are a single person, okay? You can just obey the orders of a single person, right? There are so many managers at some above stage than you. If all are giving you some responsibilities for these, all are your boss, okay, then as per whom you will gonna work? You will be confused, right? As if you, being a worker, you are supposed to comply the orders of your superior one, right? So thus, it is the unity of command which says single individual employee means single boss, okay? That is, only one boss should be there for one person. Otherwise, he will got confused at what kind of responsibilities he should perform, okay? And or we can say that in case the principle of unity of command will be violated, the consequences of such principle will lead to either authority is undermined or discipline is in jeopardy. Order is disturbed or even stability is in threat. Okay, so these are the basic reasons due to which we are supposed to obey this principle. Okay, coming toward the next principle, the fifth principle is your unity of direction, which says one heart and one plan. It means that there is an organization. Okay, here is your head and there are so many people who are working in his supervision, right? Thus, in case the single person is having so many tasks to perform, so many organizational goals are there, then what will happen is he himself will got confused, right? Thus, what this principle says that for an organization, there should be single direction and all the personnel should have unity in going towards that particular direction. That is, for the organization goal, for the achievement of that organization goal, whatever the head had selected the direction, whatever direction one had chosen, all should have unity to go towards that. Okay. The next principle is your subordination of individual interest to general interest. So friends, first of all, tell me one thing, what do you mean by subordination? Subordination means taking something not as priority, right? So it says that individual interest should be subordinated in front of the general interest. That means the organizational interest should be given priority as compared to the individual interest. The reason behind this is that organization is having so many people in itself. Say there are so many stakeholders are there, whether they are the workers, they are the owners, they are the shareholders, or they are the creditors, they are the customers, right? So as if you can see that in an organization there are so many stakeholders, there are so many people who are linked with who are having some interest with the organization. If only the interest of the worker will be taken care of, or you can say if only the shareholders' interest will be taken care of, then what will happen is the others will be suffered, right? Thus, it says that organizational interest should be given priority as compared to the individual interest. Okay, now coming toward the next principle, the seventh principle is your remuneration of employees. As per this principle, the remuneration given to the employees should be just and equitable, which means that employee working at same level should be given the equal wage. Otherwise, what will happen is, in case he is working with the same efficiency which the other person is working, he should be given the same wage which the other one is given. Say two workers A and B. A is more efficient and B is less efficient. But the superior of A who is working even less than A, then but still as if he is at the same stage, right? He is at some higher stage. Thus, A should be given some extra bonus for his work so that he will feel satisfied. He will feel justified in that organization. Okay? Thus, it is basically the responsibility of your of the organization to maximize the satisfaction of both employers and organization to pay just and equitable remuneration to its employees so that good relations between worker and management can be maintained. Good relations between worker and management can be maintained. Okay. The next principle is centralization and decentralization. Centralization and decentralization. Okay, first of all, let's discuss about the meaning. There are two organizations, AB Limited and BC Limited. BC Limited. So, in your AB Limited, it is the top level management who make all the policy and tell the others to follow. Okay, there are, whether it is your middle level management or lower level management or the workers, all are supposed to follow. No one can discuss to the top level management regarding what they want. So this is your centralized, where all the power to take decision will lies in the hand of top level management. Okay, in your BC or limited, it is your top level, it is your top level management, it is middle, lower, and here it is your workers. So in this organization, it the chain doesn't move from top to middle to lower to worker, but workers or the lower or the middle, all are having authority. The authority is basically delegated to all the level of management so that they can discuss to any of the person of the organization, whether it is between worker or top level management. Basically here the ideas of the worker or the lower level management are also invited by the top level management. Here it is basically your friendly environment, and thus it is your decentralized organization. Okay, so friends, why we had taken this as a principle? As per the Fayol, what Fayol says, as if both are having their own merits and demerits, which you will gonna learn in your fourth chapter, your organizing. But here, what Fayol mean to say is, as if both are having their own advantages and disadvantages. If you can see that if it will be completely centralized, then satisfaction will be lower to the workers, right? And if it will be decentralized, then there will be so many gossip or humors which can spread in a second, right? Thus, there should be balance between both. Balance between both, whether it is centralization or decentralization, okay? And it is in the top level management to set the limit of centralization as well as decentralization. Coming toward the next principle, it is your ninth principle, which is your scalar chain. Scalar chain. As per this principle, in an organization, there are so many superior and subordinates are there, right? See, it is your top level management who is having two departments. Here it is your production department, and here it is your marketing department. Okay, but both are the part of the same organization. Thus, these are the here top level management subordinate, here his subordinate, it's his subordinate, and here it is his subordinate. Again, subordinates in the marketing department. So friends, here these are four, and here also these are four. Okay, so friends, what by scalar chain we mean is, this is basically your scalar chain, which says that one should follow this chain while communicating. Say here it is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Even though A and H are at the same level, still to discuss with each other, they are supposed to follow. First of all, they are required to discuss to his superior B, then to C, then to D. C will discuss to D, D will discuss to top level management, and top level management will gonna discuss to the marketing management in the sequence E, then F, F will discuss to G, and after that it will reach H. Okay, so this is what we mean by scalar chain, that in an organization one should follow the scalar chain to communicate with the higher or the other department. Okay, but here comes a limitation of this principle, which says that in case one want to discuss, say A want to discuss to H, so he is supposed to follow the complete chain, but it will lead to delay, right? As if they are at the same level, and if they are not supposed to focus on the same, say B is required to communicate to G. Thus, the Fayol created a new principle in it. The chain he had created named as gangplank, which says that in the case of emergency, the subordinate or the employee at the same level can discuss to the other employee at the same level at the time of emergency using gangplank. Okay, so this is your ninth principle. Coming towards the tenth principle, which is your order. It means there should be a proper place for everything or everyone, and these everything or everyone should be at the proper place, should be at their proper place. Just like if you have ever visited a library, okay, in a library there are so many bookshelves are there. Each shelf, say this one is for science department, this one is for commerce, this one is for arts department, this is for your general knowledge department. So over here, as if it will, what with the help of these sequence, what will happen is one who belongs to the science department can easily visit to the library and bring the book. Otherwise, in case he is not aware about which of the department is for science, then he is supposed to go through with the complete library, right? Thus, proper order is required to be set out so that one can easily find the right thing at right time and delay will be reduced. Okay, coming towards the next principle, the 11th principle is your equity. And I guess in your economics and your previous classes, whether it is your 11th economics as well, you might have learned about the term equity. So what we mean by equity? Equity means there should be no discrimination should be there based on sex, nationality, age, religion, language, caste, or even say belief should be there. So it says that as per this, basically this principle emphasizes on kindliness and justice in the behavior of manager toward workers, so that he will not discriminate his workers on these basis and will gonna treat them in the basically in a unbiased way. Okay, coming towards the next principle, your 12th principle is your stability of personnel. This principle is basically meant to the stability of tenure, which says stability of tenure, and tenure in itself refers to the your personnel, your staff member. This principle says that once you had selected your employee, once one employee had been selected for a particular post, employee has selected, say marketing strategies development, Okay, in that case, same person should be kept at that particular post for a long period of time. And that is why contract, have you ever listened that when you ever visit to an organization, they will you are required to sign up a contract that you will not gonna leave the organization for some period of time. Otherwise, in case of breach of contract, you are supposed to pay something as penalty, right? So this is what the organization do for the stability of tenure. The reason behind this is, in case you, this is the person whom you had selected. Okay, now after 1 month, as if he is now aware about your personal information, your secrecy, he is having your secret or your personal matters, right? So in case he will, after a month, he will join your competitor's organization, then what will happen is your secrecy will got leaked, because here whatever strategies you were using, he will gonna discuss it with your competitors, right? Thus what will happen is you will gonna lose the competitive advantage in the market. One more thing, in case there is no stability of personnel in your organization, that particular organization will be having loss of goodwill in the market, because no one will want to work with such organization whose tenure is not stable, as if they will found that this organization, this particular organization is not paying properly or is not having proper or good environment for the employees. They are not behaving in a good manner with its employees. Thus, no one will wanna prefer to work with you. Okay. So this is the 12th principle. Now coming toward the next principle, the 13th principle is your initiative. Initiative. So friends, as if I guess you guys are also aware about the term. What we mean by initiating? By initiative, we mean the eagerness to initiate without even ask. Say, you were not asked to do something. Okay, but still, as if you are interested in doing something, you will take the responsibility by yourself. So when one is taking responsibility by himself, without one asked to do so, do it. In that case, it will be known as initiative. So friends, as per the Fayol, subordinate should be encouraged to make and execute plan within the prescribed limit of authority. And this is what one mean by taking initiative. And thus we mean that the employer should take initiative in organizational plans and programs. Okay, coming towards the last principle. The last principle of Henry Fayol is your esprit de corps. Esprit de corps, which means unity is strength. Unity is strength. As per Henry Fayol, what Henry Fayol suggested is one should promote unity in an organization, because unity provides strength. We all are aware about the story of the farmer who had given woods to his son and said to broke them one by one, and after that he gave them a bundle to broke it completely, and those branches were not broke, right? Thus, unity is strength was the moral of that story. Similarly, here also your Henry Fayol suggested that I should be replaced with we, and all the members of the management, whether they are worker, or the management, they should work with harmony rather than working individually. Okay, so friends, these are your principles which are provided by Fayol. If you like our classes, please download our app Scholars Learning. And in case you have already downloaded our app, hope you guys are enjoying learning by our classes. Thank you.